have several zucchinis I need to get cooking because I've had them for a while since my last grocery haul. Excuse me. So I'm going to go ahead and make some zucchini fries. I already went ahead and washed this up. Got it dried out. I've been letting it set out all day because I didn't want it to be cold. You're going to need a ninja or some kind of processor to grind up your pork rinds. And I am using the Clancy's original pork rinds, and they're from the Dollar Tree. They're the best ones I've found so far that taste delicious. They have enough salt on them. So I'm going to go ahead and use these pork rinds for my, to bread them. So in here I have a whole bag here already ready, whipped up and ready to go. Now I have to go find my pork rinds. Found it. Alright. Thought I was ready. Alright, so give me a sec. Let me get this going. It's all twisted up. I'm refusing to plug in for me. Alright. Let's get that over there so that tightens up. This here. We'll get a nice shot. Let's see if we can get a shot with that. And can we see it? We can see it. So take a quick picture through it. And then we're going to use cucumber, the usual seasoning, Firehouse, my pork rinds, the original from Clancy's, and you're going to need a Food Ninja or a blender, or you can just crush up your pork rinds, because we're going to be making like a panko to put in for the crumbs. So, and I'm going to get a couple eggs out. I believe I can do this with one egg. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that picture again since I left it out. Alright, but I have two set out. This started. We're going to put this off to the side. And I need. Okay, here and here. Alright. So I want my breadcrumbs in here. I'm going to be putting. I'm just going to go ahead and crack two eggs in here. Nice wet towel, just in case I make a mess, just like I did. Okay, and then instead of me taking and dipping these one by one, all I'm going to do is I'm going to take my two eggs, beat them up, and then I'm just going to throw my zucchini fries in here, just to coat them really good. And then I'll be able to throw them in here. And that should stay right there. So we got that done taken care of. I'm going to set this to the side. And grab my knife. And I'm going to go ahead and cut my zucchini fries. You can cut them as small as you want, as large as you want. You can just do chunks. I don't want them super crispy, you know, but I don't want them soggy either, so they're going to be just right. All cut them into strips. And then I'm going to cut them into french fry size, which, should I do big? Let's see if we can get 3 sets of fries out of these. Okay, and they're just going to be just like that. So I'm going to throw them in. Really foul. My pork fell in. I had it sitting just right, and I bumped it. All right, so we're going to get another one. See, guys? Nothing ever turns out the way you want it to when you're recording. It just doesn't. But that's okay. We're going to move on. So I'm just going to throw these in here. And they are going to be mixed up. I need a fork for this. So. And you're just going to want to make sure that your zucchini is good and coated, which I'm going to cut the rest of this up and put it in here. But the trick is now I'm going to stab the fork. If you want to peel your zucchini, go right ahead. Do what you like. Some people seed it out, but these seeds are very thin, and they're not going to bug me whatsoever. So we are just going to go ahead and do that. Some people might like a little lesser of a thicker fry, but this is not going to bother me one bit, so they look. So I'm just going to make sure these are good and coated, and while they're sitting in here, I'm going to go ahead and make our panko. Alright, let's get that stabbed in there, get it set off to the side. Now, for our panko, you can guys see, I can bring you a little closer. There we go. So we got that in there. Oh, it's a little bit too smooth. So let's hang this back. You're going to grind up. Oh, I think they said half of a bag. I mean, just go according to how many you want to have breaded. So I'm just going to do until I can cover mine in there. And I find that. And it's going to be loud for just a minute. For me, it only takes a couple pulses, and it's done. So evidently, I'm going to be using, and it's going to be just like this. I'm going to be using a lot more than just that for my breadcrumbs. So I'm going to add more. Easy. Put this on here and bring you a little bit closer. My tripod don't want to fall. All right, let's get that tightened up. So this is the consistency that you want to have. You can have it a little bit thinner to make it some nice breadcrumbs, but I don't want mine too thin because then they'll turn oily and gelatinous for pork rinds. Alright, now let me set my camera back up. Without pushing buttons here. Alright, I have my air fryer. We're going to be cooking that in the air fryer today. And I forgot to cut my sheet. I forgot to do this earlier, so we just gotta do this now. Okay, so I'm gonna lay down my basket, and here I cut me a little round piece of parchment paper, and I'm gonna set that in there like that. It's just for an easier cleanup, not so much of a mess. Okay. Now on my seasoning, I think I'm going to be using about a tablespoon, and it might be a bit much. But we're going to check it out. Whoa! And this seasoning has everything in it, the usual seasoning. Been really addicted to this lately, and I'm gonna make sure this is thoroughly mixed, and then making a mess, and then I'm gonna give it a taste to see if I need to add more, because of course that is perfect. Alright, so 1 tablespoon, that is gonna give it all the seasonings it needs. Wow, that's delicious. I'm gonna clean up my mess here. And there we go. So now we have our panko chips. Now it's time to get messy. So, but thank goodness we have a fork. And then let me see if I can do this. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my zucchini that's been soaking in this egg wash here. Just eggs, nothing else, no salt, no pepper. Because it has been on there. In there. Alright, so I'm going to take one, put it in the panko chips, and just coat it. Okay? And then I'm going to put it in there, in our air fryer. And it sticks really well, so you don't have to worry about anything. You know, the panko chips doing anything else, it's gonna stick to it really good. Oh gosh. Alright. Get it fully coated on the back here. Looks delicious, guys. I can't wait to eat some of these. And I'm gonna try and get this video out and posted today, well, tonight. It is currently 8:04 Saturday night there. I hope you guys are going to have a wonderful weekend. Alright. Okay. got it nice and coated. Got it in there. Alright, and as you can see, I did not overcrowd them. Whoa. They are... I got 8 of them in here, so I'm going to stick them in here, and I'm going to cook them at 400 degrees for about 8 to 10 minutes. Let's try 12. I'll do 12 minutes. And then I will update and let you guys know exactly how much time it takes. Until then, I'm going to go ahead and make me some more panko. Pork rind chips, and then that way I can get this started. Okay, it's been there for 8 minutes. What I did is I took some of fresh Parmesan cheese, which you guys can't quite see because I tore the package open so that way I can freshly did it. So I stuck some in here. Roughly, probably about, I'd say 1/4 cup. And, let's see. Third. Get this right for you guys. Well, it's about half. Let me see. Yep, 1/2 cup of fresh Parmesan, and this is going to be for my second batch. Let me get all this back in here, so I'm not making a big mess. Get this back over here. All right, so I added the Parmesan to my panko. I'm going to mix this up, and then I'm going to coat the eggs, or the zucchini, and I'm also going to cook it just like that, and then we'll compare. I've got my dish out already, ready for the zucchini to come out. It has 3 minutes left. I'm going to check it here in a minute. Some people may want it extra firm, extra crunchy, but I'm going to check it at 12 minutes and see if that works. Okay, that's all ready to go. Hi, buddy. What are you doing? What are you doing? And my dog is looking for a treat. I know that this chops off my head. You guys cannot see me talking. But I still haven't quite figured out the camera angle that I want to get. I could do video on top of video. But as of right now, I just want to get this recipe fully on focus for you guys. Changes are coming soon, I promise. So I'm getting better and better as time goes by. All right, got a couple other recipes I'm going to be doing tonight, so that way I know I'm behind on videos. I just had a pressing event this week that was very sad, and I lost my Jezebel, almost 11 years old. So we have just Tanner, and we love her deeply, and we miss her a lot. So I haven't been doing videos. I do apologize, but I just needed that time to adjust. But now we're going to be back in the habit. We're going to be getting some videos out, some recipes out for y'all, and we're going to move forward. Huh, buddy? Yes, huh, buddy? Alright, it says 1 minute remaining. Guys, this chocolate cheese is addicting. It is so good. Marais Gruyere. That is such a good cheese, guys. I mean, it was, let's see, it was $22.25, and they marked it down to $11.19, so I had to snag it, and it is super delicious. I've been sitting here snacking on it. Just cutting a piece off and eating. And I made my cucumber salad again, getting ready for Father's Day tomorrow. We're going to have ribeye steaks and cucumber salad. And I might make a couple extra things. I'm not quite sure. All right. lid is off, so we're gonna check it. Ooh, those look good. Oh, they're delicious. All right. They are delicious. I could just stick the fork in it right away. They're crispy. And they're also soft. I don't recommend you leaving these just lying around because there's so much moisture in there. Kind of cook what you can eat. And we have one in here that's hard, but it's going to be a taste tester. I'm telling you. That looks super delicious. I can't wait to try it. And that looks yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay, so I'm going to get these ones in with the Parmesan cheese. I'm going to set these off back here. And we are going to taste test those. But as of right now, I am going to get these in here so we can get them going. And I can't wait to taste how much different the Parmesan cheese tastes on this versus the regular, just the regular chips or the regular pork rind panko. Get it to stay on here. All right. Egg in there. Tiny one here. And we're going to do the same amount because you don't want to overcrowd your fryer. If you overcrowd your fryer, it's just not going to get done. So, and I'm just sticking 8 pieces in here. You might be able to get a couple smaller ones, get a couple more in there that are bigger. Because of their smaller sizes. One more. Those 8 in, we're gonna get those in same amount of time, 400 degrees, which is the French fry section, French fry setting, and we're gonna lower it down to 12 minutes. They turned out perfect. Okay, it looks like I have one guacamole left, so I will put that on for a side, and then I will get some mayo dressing going. Thank you. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make like a Thousand Island dressing. Except for I don't have any little pickles to put in this. So it's something that I make quite a bit. Let me see if I can find my mustard. Okay. Miss where I put them. So alright, so I'm just gonna do 2 tablespoons of mayo. Mayo of your choice. If you like to make your avocado mayo, your homemade mayo, to make this clean keto, you go right ahead. I'm skipping steps, so. And a teaspoon of mustard. Tablespoon of the G Huge sugar-free ketchup. And then I will put some salt in it if I need to. If you want to make it sweeter, you can add a little bit of monk fruit to make it as a sweeter dressing. But I will have to taste it and see. Sometimes I need a little bit more ketchup. Sometimes I need a little bit more mayonnaise. It just really depends. Or not mayonnaise, mustard. Because sometimes it just tastes like I mean, if you had that pickle juice, that would really set it off to make it taste like a Big Mac sauce. But we're not wanting this to taste like a Big Mac sauce. Okay. And that is great. It tastes like a Thousand Island dressing. So I did a teaspoon, probably 2 teaspoons of mustard, 1 tablespoon of ketchup, and 2 tablespoons of mayonnaise. And then I'm going to go ahead and crack some pepper in here. And mix it up, and you got a nice little sauce. I've just been making this sauce for a long, long time. I never liked Thousand Island dressing, and when I couldn't afford to buy the Thousand Island dressing, but I had the other stuff, this is what I made to put on our salads. I'm just going to put a dollop of that. Right here. Got panko chips everywhere. And then we're going to use one of the fries to dip. Definitely want to eat these fresh out of the air fryer. They'd be more crispy, but these are amazing, guys. Oh my lord. Super, super delicious. I can't wait till these other ones get done. Take some pictures up here. Oh man, super good. I can't wait to taste the Parmesan because I imagine I can stick these back in there and crisp them up a little bit more before I serve them. But this is going to be a snack that we're going to eat right away. So, and I still have some more here to get done. But 3 or 4 should be fine between the 3 of us. So I will cook this batch here. And that will be all. I was going to do more. I have, you know, quite a few. I have one more here that I could have did. But I also got some squash back there that I need cooked too. So maybe I'll cut this in half and make some stuffed zucchini boats with it, and I can make that and put that on a next video for you guys, Wow, those are super delicious. I can't wait for him to try them. He's gonna love it. I can put the rest of the guacamole on top of there. Oh, just get that and that all together, but I want to get pictures first. So super, super delicious. We got about 5 minutes left. Let me come around and check the time on you guys. About 13 minutes on the camera, so we're good to go. These will be up before then. They got 4 minutes left. So I hope you guys have been having a wonderful cooking up a storm day. I know it's been a while since a video, but I hope you guys have many blessings through this day. It's been super, super hot. The highest has been 110 here. It is a chore. So I have a new air conditioner in our back, which I'm hoping it's not too loud, but it helps me get through the cooking, so that way it's not so hot in the house. Excuse me. Yeah, I think I have allergies. I think my allergies, like, when you get older, do you guys have allergies? I've never had allergies before at all. And yesterday and today, it's just been crazy. I've been sneezing and sneezing and sneezing. It doesn't seem to go away. I'm like, the older you get, the more stuff you get, it seems like. So excited. And oh, those turned out even more crispy. Oh, they look super delicious, y'all. Oh, and the crunch is so much more. Those two got close together with the cheese. Oh, these are gonna be a hit. These ones are super crispy. All right, guys, I'm on this one. I'd hate to say it's a zucchini battle, but you know what? I think the Parmesan is going to just totally conquer this one. Oh my goodness, so super delicious. So I'm gonna get some fries. Some screenshot of this, get some pictures going, and move on to the next recipe. So, all right. Thank you guys for joining me. You guys have a wonderful cooking up a storm day. This is the zucchini with the Parmesan and the panko. And this is the zucchini with just the panko and the seasonings. And this has a seasoning in too. I just add the Parmesan to it. Super delicious, super yummy. Can't wait to try them. All right. You guys have a wonderful cooking up a storm day. Bye-bye now.